Hi, this is Ahil here, and let's study the reproductive system today.
What topics will we be covering in this video? In this video, I will be introducing you to the concept of reproduction, and I will explain the male reproductive system. Now that you are in class 10, you should be able to define reproduction, and you should also know that reproduction is of two types, sexual and asexual. So let's first define reproduction. Reproduction is the formation of new individuals by sexual or asexual means, which can repeat the process in their own turn. An asexual means is like an amoeba by the process of fission, just dividing the cell into two parts. And sexual means is like in humans by production of gametes, which are actually sex cells. For those who do not understand the meaning of gametes, gametes are sex cells. They are produced by gonads. Gonads are organs or sex organs that produce gametes, the sex cells. Sperms are male sex cells and eggs are female sex cells, as you can see in the diagram I have shown you on screen. During reproduction, a sperm and an egg cell fuse together to form zygote. This is the first cell, and every human being is formed from this first zygote cell, and this process is called fertilization, as you should know, and then this zygote develops into an offspring. Male and female have features that are different from one another. These features are called secondary sexual characters. For example, in males, deeper voice, strongly built, and beard and mustache. These are all the male secondary sexual characters. And in females, breasts and wider hips to accommodate uterus. These are their secondary sexual characters. Now let's start the next topic, reproduction in humans. The reproductive system of humans is divided into two parts, primary and accessory parts. So the primary reproductive organs, they are called gonads, and they are organs that produce gametes or the sex cells. Male gonad organs are called testes, and they produce sperms, male gametes, and female gonads are called ovaries, and these produce female gametes called eggs. Next, the accessory reproductive organs, they include all ducts, glands, and other structures that help in transfer of sex cells. First, let's study the male reproductive system. This system has seven main organs, and they are testes, sperm duct, bulbourethral glands, seminal vesicles, prostate glands, and penis. It also has urethra. If you want to score high marks in ICSE class 10 biology, you should know every single organ's shape, location, and function in every single lesson. Now let's study about testes. So now let's study the function, location, and shape of the testes. Testes is an oval organ, so shape is oval. Its location is in the scrotum. So the testes is contained in the scrotum. And what is scrotum? Scrotum is the thin-walled sac of skin that helps in temperature regulation of testes. We'll see a little more about temperature regulation later. So, and function of the testes is to produce sperms. So now coming back to the temperature regulation done by the scrotum, sperms are produced in our body at a temperature of 2 to 3 degrees Celsius, lower than that of the body. And this temperature is regulated by the strange movements of the scrotal sac. When the temperature is too high or when the body is too hot, the scrotum loosens and hence hangs down, moving away from the body, thereby reducing the temperature of the testes. When the body temperature is too cold, the scrotum skin contracts and gets closer to the body for more warmth. Now let's study the structure of testes. Testes has many parts. It's divided into many parts. They are seminiferous tubules, interstitial or Leydig cells, efferent duct, and epididymis. So let's start with seminiferous tubules. Seminiferous tubules are highly coiled structures. They produce sperms, and the process of production of sperms is called spermatogenesis. Then the next one is interstitial cells or Leydig cells. They are also interstitial cells are also called Leydig cells. They produce hormones like testosterone, and they pack seminiferous tubules. They wrap around the seminiferous tubules, and yeah, they serve for packing purposes. Efferent ducts are ducts through which mature sperms move from the seminiferous tubules to the epididymis. So the function of the efferent duct is basically to connect testis and epididymis. And then there is also another duct called ejaculatory duct. This duct is the duct through which semen enters the penis. The next part is the epididymis. Its shape is a small tubular knot. Its location is it fits like a cap on the upper pole of the testis, and it has two main functions. The first one is to allow a passage to the sperms into the sperm duct. It's also called vas deferens. The sperm duct is also called vas deferens. And the second function is to store the sperms till they get mature and become motile. Motile is active. The meaning of motile is active. This epididymis is a very prominent and big structure, and hence it has many parts like the head of the epididymis, the body of the epididymis, and the tail of the epididymis. So we studied about all the parts of testis. Now let's come to the sperm duct. The sperm duct is also called vas deferens. It travels upward into the abdomen, passing through the inguinal canal. What is this inguinal canal? Inguinal canal is the canal through which the testis descends into the scrotum during birth. So there are times when the pressure in the abdomen increases, and it leads to the bulging of the intestine into the scrotum. This problem is called hernia. The function of the sperm duct is to connect with the ureter and join at the urethra at the back of the urinary bladder. They kind of loop around the ureter. Now let's move on to the seminal vesicle. Seminal vesicles are lobulated pair of glands. Their location is between rectum and posterior surface of the urinary bladder. They have two functions. First one is to unite sperm duct to urethra. The red tube is the sperm duct, and the circle I have drawn is the urethra. The second one is to produce secretion for transportation of sperms. So let's see what this liquid semen is. Semen is the secretion of the seminal vesicle plus the sperms. So the secretion of the seminal vesicle along with the sperms itself is the semen. So next we are going to look at the prostate glands. Their shape is bilobed, and their location is the prostate gland surrounds the urethra close to its origin from the bladder, as I'm going to circle out in the diagram on the screen. And its function is to make an alkaline secretion and pour it into the semen that neutralizes the acidic effect in the female's vagina. So the next organ is bulbourethral glands. They are also called Cowper's glands. Their shape is ovoid. So these are two ovoid glands. Their location is they open into the urethra before it enters the penis. Its function is to make a secretion that serves as a lubricant. The last part we are going to study in this video is penis. It is the male copulatory organ, and it's a highly vascular organ. So you should note this term, highly vascular organ. And its shape is cylindrical. Its location is in front of the scrotum, and its function is it helps in the passing of urine and semen out of the body. And now you should also know the condition of the penis called erection. Under sexual stimulation, blood flows in excess and fills all the empty spaces and sinuses in the penis, and the penis hence becomes rigid, and this condition of the penis is called erection. So it's time for some diagrams. So let's draw the diagram of the testis.
Now that we have studied all the structures of the testes, we should be able to draw this structure of the testes very easily. So let's give it a try. So let's start. We are going to start by drawing the testes, the shape of the testes. As we saw, it was oval.
Yes.
Oval. And then inside this oval, we have seminal vesicles. Oops, this is supposed to be like this. So we learned that the seminal vesicles are highly coiled substances that produce sperms. Right? Do you remember? Don't worry, if you think you cannot follow, I will give you a quick recap in the end of the video after these drawings. Okay, so you don't have to worry. So what happens is, these seminiferous tubules produce sperms. So let me draw a small sperm. So these sperms, after they get mature, they travel from the seminiferous tubules into the efferent ducts. So let me draw the efferent duct. Efferent ducts. From these efferent ducts, they go to the epididymis. The epididymis, as we studied in this video. It sort of looks like a snake, and this top part bulges because this is the head of the epididymis, the body of the epididymis, and the tail of the epididymis. So from here they travel through this efferent duct, and they travel from the head of the epididymis down to the tail. And then what happens, friends? This epididymis gets continued into the sperm duct, and the sperm duct again goes up. So then the sperm again travels up. Okay? So what happens? The seminiferous tubule, they produce the sperm. And the sperm, after they get mature, they travel from the seminiferous tubules to the epididymis via this efferent duct. And from this head of the epididymis, they travel down to the body of the epididymis and the tail of the epididymis. And then they travel upwards through the sperm duct. And where do they go from the sperm duct? Any guesses? We studied in this video that the sperm duct gets continued into the ureter, and they join the lower part of the base of the urinary bladder. This is the urinary bladder. Okay. That's the urinary bladder, and they join the urinary bladder here. From both sides, of course, from another testis, this sperm duct comes. So from here, they pass into the urethra. From the urethra, and this is the penis. Okay, and then they go into the female's vagina. Hope that was clear. If you found my explanations in this video useful, you can go ahead and watch the second part of the reproductive system lesson. I'm going to play a quick recap so that you can note down all the key points, functions, locations, shapes, and also everything else. And please make sure you don't miss this. Thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching, all of you. If you want me to make more videos, just type in the topic name of the video in the comment section. I want you to rate my video on a scale of 1 to 10. It would be lovely if you did that. Stay safe, enjoy, good luck, bye.